Hopefully it works out. So we can draw a recall or a shattering spree again. Maybe we'll need to play it this time. But yeah, that game, we only played the Serum Visions, the Pestermite, and the Kiki Jiki. Three cards are good enough, but sometimes that's how it is. Like, Pestermite and Deceiver X Arch are really nice against Affinity decks. They buy a lot of time. They're good in combat. And then they're good for the kill, too. Alright, I mean, this isn't a mulligan. It's a little bit awkward for having Shattering Spree. We're definitely hoping to hit Cascade Bluffs. Otherwise, it's not even that good, and this hand is real clunky. Thirst for Knowledge, probably too slow. If we hit a second red source, that'll be great, but this hand's definitely on the awkward end of the spectrum. Maybe we draw Vial turn one, that'd be great as well. Pestermite is a good one, but we need land more than anything. So just pray to baby Jesus for a Cascade Bluffs. Or even a Tectonic Edge, you know, just any kind of land at this point. We have just a really juiced hand. Even other Vial would maybe be fast enough, although I doubt it. Thirst for Knowledge looking real bad here, as opposed to, I don't know, Remand, that was the thing, or Mistbind Click. We didn't have another cheap option in the board. Maybe that's a problem. I was thinking that some kind of nice, or even Cunning Spark Mage or something like that could be really good. Is it Staticaster? Yeah. Is it Staticaster? Something like that could be good. I keep having to wait for the opponent. You notice the opponent's used 15 minutes to our 7 minutes, roughly. 8 minutes. 8 minutes, 11 minutes. Yeah, opponent's just real. It's doing other things. I don't know. And it's definitely annoying. But whatever, people are going to do it. We could also maybe use Pestermite for more red mana. That happens a fair amount. Okay, well, let's see what we can do. We did draw our third land, and that'll buy us a lot of time. Opponent only has 3 cards left. We have reasonable answers, so hoping for the best. Not mad about Island, but again, Cascade Bluffs would just be a ludicrous draw. Okay. I think just throwing Spellstutter in front of Vault Scourge is pretty reasonable. I don't think we're going to catch anything with it. I feel like zeros would have been played by now. And I want to keep as many artifacts off the field as possible so that we could Shattering Spree and then not have modular counters to deal with, potentially. That's the ideal for sure. Pestermite will buy a little bit of time. Or Etched Champion. Tech Edge. Etched Champion, definitely annoying. Definitely annoying. I'm going to pass the turn. We're a couple red away from Kiki Jiki, so we're really desperate for a Cascade Bluffs. We still have 20 life, and if the opponent doesn't, if we can avoid taking Cranial Plating or massive modular hits, then we'll be alright. But we can potentially keep the opponent off Metalcraft if things go right as well. So this might be a turn that we Pestermite. Although I'm thinking this is going to be a turn that we Thirst for Knowledge. Potentially. We could have even Shattering Spreed one thing this turn. And Shatterstorm looking way better as well, so. Yeah, Shattering Spree is not performing this game. So it'll be interesting for sure, though, as we decide how to do this. Or we could even, during our turn right now, Pestermite and Shattering Spree Ravager. Just to get more stuff going on. So it would be a good tempo play. And then turn the next turn we could play Sower. And maybe... Yeah, but then the issue is if Cranial Plating comes down, we're just going to lose. So back to F6 plan. Opponent finally comes back. Ornithopter. Relic. Signal Pest. So this is very scary. We could Pester Mite. I think that playing Thirst for Knowledge is the way to go here. Dig for Hercule's Recall, Cascade Bluffs. Try to maybe set up for a win on the following turn. So that's pretty horrendous. We can lose Tech Edge for sure. And then I think Spellstutter Sprite, because Sower and these other cards do a lot and contribute more. Island. Getting punished for the greedy mana base right now. So my game plan is to Serum Visions and Pester Mite this turn. We're still at 17 life, so we're okay. Scion of Una. So many lands that are not Cascade Bluffs. So I don't think Scion of Una is going to win this game. I think Cascade Bluffs will. So here we could Pester Mite and Shattering Spree one thing. We could also try to save the Pester Mite. That's not really an option anymore. I think Pester Mite needs to tap the Signal Pest. Or we could even let this... Yeah, Pester Mite needs to tap the Signal Pest. Okay. Well, yeah, so... The mana base is greedy. That's definitely true. Okay, praying to not see a plating, because that's gonna... really cut our draw steps out. Actually, the fact that we have Mutavault to block Etched Champion is pretty good. So hopefully the opponent ends up missing that. Also, hopefully we don't get Galvanic Blasted. But if we do get Galvanic Blasted, it means we get to Sower. Tap Signal Pest. It's a grind. Okay, two only is fine. Let's see what's falling up. Plating. Well, we do have the Mutavault to block. Weird that that didn't happen before, but I guess we had mana up. Yuck. Alright, well, I have to try to make the most of this situation. Maybe we draw Cascade Bluffs. I hope the toughness goes somewhere that's not the Etched Champion. Yeah, man, this is horrendously ugly. Okay, well, things are getting humped, I guess. Okay. Definitely problematic. We can Shattering Spree the plating. Finally just get that out of our hand. And then, I don't know, it looks like we're in a position where we draw Cascade Bluffs. We win, and we might have a few turns to do it. Pester Mite can comfortably attack here. It's not blocking an Ornithopter that's buffed. Computer's running low. Alright. Moving to the bed here. As I've been recording on the my standing desk, which is away from the power plug, but... Actually, you know what? I'm gonna move to the floor. Put the computer on the bed. Sit on the ground. I prefer this. Okay, well, the opponent only has one card left. Has drawn two basics, and it's curious to even see two. Not Tezzeret. Well, we do have Mutavault for that, so... Again, we draw Cascade Bluffs, and... We can just win. We have a Spell Stutter Sprite. So I feel pretty safe attacking with the Pester Mite. Although it probably doesn't matter because, again, we just need to draw Cascade Bluffs or... Yeah, and if we weren't playing Sky Hussar, Hallowed Fountain would be Cascade Bluffs. So you can make that adjustment if you wanted. Opponent's running out of time. Oh, here comes everybody. Have I made a mistake by letting... It's going to take too much damage. Looks like it. Animate. Well, no, we can't block with Pester Mite. We need to keep it. That's our way to win. Alright. Mutavault trades here. Sower eats Thopter. Conclave eats Signal Pest. And we're taking 7 going to 4, so we need to draw Hercule's Recall, Mutavault, or Cascade Bluffs in order to win and end with a 2-1 record. Wait. The opponent's pretty light on artifacts, so maybe Snapcaster Mage could do it too. But it's coming out of top deck. We won 2 today, whatever. I mean, adjustments can be made. Scalding Tarn. Ah, it's too bad. It's too bad. The Kiki's super stranded, and I let this happen. 4. 1, 2, 3. It's such a fine margin between victory and defeat. One more life, maybe. No, one more life wouldn't do it. It's vulnerable right now. It is. So, oh well. I mean... Close games. I don't mind. 1-2 finish doesn't feel good, but you can see the power of the deck. This is competitive and matches up reasonably against Affinity for sure. I don't know about... Although this mana base is perplexing. I don't think the opponent has Ink Moths, which I guess definitely make things way easier for us. I didn't spell stutter that, which is a mistake, but I was also not really caring because if we counter it, opponent activates Blink Moth, and they have Metalcraft anyways, and attacking for the kill. So I guess we could have played for some kind of egregious mistake, but this is just the same, playing for the opponent to click through the attack. Anyways, much love, good luck to those of you guys who want to play a deck like this or another Vial deck, and peace.